In this lecture, I'm going to introduce bada's runtime namespace. I'm going to introduce you to the timer, thread, and synchronization classes of the runtime namespace. The runtime namespace includes classes related to timer classes, threads, and data synchronization between threads. Let's start by looking at the timer class. The timer class notifies an object of a timeout when a period of time has passed. The timer class has the construct start and cancel functions. For the construct function, you can add a listener object to receive a timeout object when the period of time has passed. In this way, if the event listener is defined in the construct function and the start function is called, the timer starts. You can define the timeout duration by specifying the start function parameter in millisecond units. To stop a running timer, you can call the cancel function. The timer class calls the onTimerExpired function of the event listener object after the period of time specified in the start function. Let's take a look at some sample code where the timer is used directly. The code is part of a program that performs an operation every 10 milliseconds. First, to perform the operation every 10 milliseconds, the foo subclass of the iTimerEventListener has been defined that receives timer events. Then, the startTimer function is implemented to start the timer in the program. This function constructs the timer, adds the listener, and then calls the start function. For this start function, the timeout parameter has been set to 10, so that the onTimerExpired function is called after 10 milliseconds. The onTimerExpired function performs the desired operation and then restarts the timer operation so that the onTimerExpired function will be called again. Next, let's have a look at bada's thread class. Threads are basically used to create multiple control flows that can run simultaneously. In bada, there are two types of thread. One is a worker thread, and the other is an event-driven thread. In general, while a worker thread is created to perform relatively long operations in parallel with the main thread, an event-driven thread is created to handle events independent of the main thread. Therefore, an event-driven thread can be implemented using an asynchronous call, but a worker thread cannot use an asynchronous call. Bada's thread programming model basically uses the iRunnable interface. This iRunnable interface is the base class of the thread class and has a virtual function, run. You can create a thread by implementing the code in the run virtual function. The class derived from the iRunnable interface is the thread class. The thread class has the onStart, run, and onStop virtual functions. Okay, let's see how a thread operates. If the main thread constructs a subthread and calls the start function of the thread, the onStart virtual function of the thread is called, and then the thread enters the run state. The run function is also a virtual function that the developer should implement. You can implement any operations to be performed by the thread here. While the subthread is running, if the main thread calls the stop function of the subthread, the thread stops, and the onStop function of the thread is called. So let's look at how to create an actual thread. First, I'll show you how to create a thread using iRunnable. As you can see in this example, the subclass of iRunnable has been specified in the ATask class, and the run function has been implemented. You can directly specify the operation that should be performed by the thread in the run function. To use iRunnable, create a new thread in the main thread or subthread, create a task, and then add the task to the thread. If the thread is started, the default implementation of the onStart thread is called, and then the run function in the iRunnable is performed. During the operation, if the main thread that created this thread or the stop function is called, the run function is stopped, and the default implementation of the thread, the onStop function, is called. This sample code shows how to use the thread class by inheriting the thread class. In general, to use the thread class by inheriting it, you have to implement four functions. The first function is the construct function. In the construct function, you have to set the thread to be either a worker thread or an event-driven thread. The next function to be implemented is the onStart function. The onStart function initializes the thread. The next function to be implemented is the onStop function. The onStop function is called when the thread is terminated and returns all the resources created in the thread. The last function to be implemented is the run function as iRunnable. The actual operation of the thread is implemented in this function. Of course, to exit the thread currently in progress, you have to call the exit function of the thread. This sample code shows how to call the thread that was created in the previous example. You need to create, construct, and then start the thread. Then the thread runs. To stop the thread in progress, call the stop function. Then the thread stops, and the onStop function of the thread is called. This event-driven thread sample code creates a thread that performs an operation periodically by using the timer event. First, the class corresponding to the thread inherits the thread class and the iTimer event listener class, because the class should use the timer event. In the construct function of the class, the thread type is set to an event-driven thread. In the onStart function of the thread, the timer is constructed with this object as the listener parameter. After that, the start function is called with the timeout parameter set to 10, so that the timer calls the onTimerExpired function in 10 milliseconds. In the onStop function, the code to stop and delete the timer has been implemented. In the onTimerExpired function, the operation to be performed periodically is implemented, and the start function of the timer is called again, so that the onTimerExpired function is called repeatedly. Since this class is an event-driven thread, the run function is not implemented. You can use the event-driven thread from another thread in the same way as a conventional worker thread. Next, I will talk about the classes related to the synchronization between threads. Bada provides the Mutex, Semaphore, and Monitor classes for synchronization. The Mutex class limits access to a resource shared with threads, so that only one thread can access the resource at a time. The Semaphore class limits access to a resource shared with threads, so that only a specific number of threads can access the resource at a time. The Monitor class is for managing a critical section. This sample code here shows how to synchronize the variable count using a mutex. As you can see in the last part of the code, the main thread creates a mutex. If a thread needs to access the variable count, the thread must acquire the mutex first. As long as the mutex is acquired by a thread, other threads cannot acquire the mutex. Then, the value of the variable count is changed, and then the mutex is released. Then another thread can access the variable count in the same way. At this time, when thread A acquires the mutex, and thread B attempts to acquire the mutex, the acquire function does not return until thread A releases the mutex. Therefore, only one thread can access the variable count at a time. This sample code shows how to use a semaphore. Now, a semaphore is intrinsically similar to a mutex, but you can specify the number of threads that can access the semaphore data simultaneously. In this example, the semaphore has been set to the variable count. As you can see in the last part of the sample code, the number of threads that can access the data is specified when the semaphore is constructed. In this sample code, only one thread has been specified to access the semaphore. So as you can see, thread A acquires the semaphore, accesses the variable, and then releases the semaphore. Thread B is implemented differently from the one in the previous sample code. The parameter 10 that is specified when the acquire function is called indicates that the function should return if the semaphore cannot be acquired within 10 milliseconds. So when the function returns, the function returns a value corresponding to success or not successful. If the return value is not successful, the corresponding operation is to be performed, since it indicates that acquiring the semaphore has failed. If the returned value is successful, the thread can access the shared resource, since it indicates that the semaphore has been acquired. This example shows you how to order jobs using the monitor. As you can see, thread A performs jobs 1 and 2, and thread B performs job 3. At this time, if job 2 in thread A is to be performed only after job 3 of thread B is performed, thread A can call the wait function for the monitor after the completion of job 1. The wait function waits and does not return until the notify function of thread B is called. Therefore, if this code is performed, the order of the job execution would be 1, 3, 2, or 3, 1, 2, so that job 2 is performed after job 3 without failure. Okay, let's wrap up this lecture. Bada supports multi-threaded applications. There are worker thread types and event-driven thread types. You can create a thread-safe application using synchronization functions such as Mutex, Semaphore, and Monitor to protect resources shared by multiple threads.